Hello and welcome to 9design 3D. Today we will make this type of liminal space gas station again. Let's go to the tutorial. First, I modeled before and I made a tutorial about the gas station in a night liminal space scene and I made a gas pump in there. If you want, you can go from the top right card and watch this video. We made this scene before as a gas station in my channel. You can go from the top right card and only we will use this gas pump from this scene. And now I will append this model for my new project. In the new project, you can choose your collection and you can add it in here. But if you make first with the watching this video and making your gas pump, you don't need to append it. Now let's make our gas station sailing. First we will add a cube, scale, and place it to the top. And after that we will mesh add a cube because we want to add concrete support column in here. Now you can scale and place it, and after that you can add your bevel modifier and Ctrl A to apply. And we will add a circle to make our gas station's supportive cylinder columns. After adding your circle, E to extrude up in tap to edit mode. And you can add a loop cut with Ctrl R, E to extrude, right click and Alt S to scale your button faces. And don't forget to check auto smooth. And for the middle part of your concrete, you can give a shape how you want. I will I to inset this top face and E to extrude down and scale it. And after that, don't forget to check auto smooth again. Now let's make bottom concrete plane. We will add a plane to our scene and scale and place it. And after that, E to extrude down. Now our first part is ready. You can choose all of this. And from the numpad 1, you can go to front view, shift it to duplicate it, and place it in the x-axis for the sides. You can tidy up your ceiling with the scaling your face in tap to edit mode. Now let's add some details for our ceiling. Now choose your bottom part of face and I to inset, E to extrude in z-axis to up. And you can add an extra loop cut with Ctrl R and scale them in a y-axis. Choose your middle face, E to extrude, right click and Alt S to scale for giving some details to this. For the separated faces, you can I to inset again and E to extrude how you want. Now we will add some loop cuts with the Ctrl R. You can choose this middle edges. And after that, Ctrl B to bevel and E to extrude, right click and Alt S to scale again. Let's add some light parts. We will add a circle for our scene and after that scale it. In tap to edit mode, E to extrude in z-axis and F to fill. I to inset and E to extrude in z-axis again a bit. And shade smooth, check your auto smooth. Now you can place it and after that shift U to duplicate for under your ceiling. And Ctrl J to join them all together. As you see, our lights are ready. Now let's make some rails front of our gas pumps. Add a circle in tap to edit mode. You can delete your half of the vertices. Choose all of them, scale in X and Z axis. And after that, E to extrude in Y axis. With A, select all, E to extrude, right click and Alt S to scale. You can shade smooth it again. Now it's time to add some bevel modifier. You can increase your segments from here. And add extra loop cuts for the bottom. In the object mode, you can scale in Y axis. We will place it and G to move for our scene. How you want, you can shape your type for gas station. If you want, you can make it, abandon it and give some damage. But I will make a bit the modern type. For the top ceiling, choose this face, I to inset and E to extrude a bit. Add a texture with Shift A. rotate and place it. And from the right text menu, you can change your font how you want. You can upload your own fonts maybe. In tab to edit mode, you can type your right. I will make it none. And under the geometry, change your depth value and extrude and offset. You can give 3D shape for your 2D text. And I will make it and leave it like that. Now, let's add some black metal material for our rails. I'm adding a material and changing my color to black. And after that, you can increase your metallic and decrease your roughness. Let's add some plaster material in here. We will add a material and go to shading tab. Before all of this, I downloaded this painted plaster material from the ambientcg.com as a 2K. I downloaded it. And choose your principal BSDF. Before this, go to Edit Preferences, Add-ons and type Node Wrangler. We will open it. You can check. And press Ctrl-Shift-T now and choose your textures map. As you see, it came in here. In tab to edit mode, select all with A and U Smart UV project to unwrap it. Choose your other blocks and last selection materialet one and Ctrl-L and link materials. It will affect for all of it. And again, choose all and U to Smart UV project for unwrap. We will make same thing for our cylinder columns. Choose all of them and last selection materialet one, Ctrl-L, link material. And after that, make same thing in tab to edit mode. Select all with A, U and unwrap. For the bottom, if you want to add some different colors for your plaster, press this new material. As you see, we have plaster but new one. You can set, for example, I made it red. And after that, between the base color and principal BSDF, I will add a color ramp in here. After the color ramp, you can change your black notes to the red. For the white note, make same thing. And you can decrease your lightness of your color. Some part of a bit look weird, you can use to unwrap here again. If you want, you can make them white and cylindrical parts you can make as a second material. For the cylinder, as you see, I will press the plus button and after that plaster red. Then I choose my faces, I assign my second material. For the middles, if you want, you can add extra details for material. You can add extra loop cut with Ctrl R, choose your middle face and assign your plaster red material. And I made same thing for the others. For the ceiling, I will add my plus material too. In the UV edit tab, if you want, you can U and Smart UV project it. And after that, from the UV edit map, you can select all and scale. I will leave it like that because I made a night scene. For the light part, I will add a white shiny material for this. For the shiny, you can decrease your roughness. For second material, plus button and type emission or what you want. Change your surface from principal BSDF to emission and assign your second material. As you see, they will glow. In the cycles render engine, you can see clearly. If you want, you can choose some faces from your sailing part and assign your second material. I will assign for this my red plaster. And assignment material as you see. You can choose which face you want and assign your first material if you want. For the none type, you can right click and convert to mesh it. I will choose my front faces and I will eye to inset a bit. I made it because I want to add second material in here as a border. For the other letters, you can make same thing. Choose the faces and eye to inset a bit. And for this, my first material, I will add a red emission. You can change your principal BSDF to emission again and change your emission color from here. For the other border parts, I will add my emission white material and I will assign it. For the outside of it, you can make same thing. Assign your material. How color you want, you can make it. That's your project. Please feel free yourself. I will make a ground. I downloaded this concrete material from the ambientcg.com. I will use it. Let's add some plane for our ground and scale it. After that, in tab to edit mode, E to extrude it up, down. As you see, you can scale it and place it. For the scale, press Shift Z for lock your axis. And I will add an array modifier to this. For the factor X, I type my value -1 and increase my count. For this, you can add your concrete material as the same method. Press Ctrl Shift T and choose your concrete material from here. And in tab to edit mode, U to unwrap it. For giving some rainy and puddle effect for your textures, you can make these things. Between the roughness and principal BSDF, I will add a color ramp and I will add some noise texture. If you slide your color ramp's black node, as you see, it will be a bit rainy and wet shiny look. From the noise texture, scale and details, you can change its type. I will make a bit rainy night. From the ground, you can shift it to duplicate and place them for the sides. If you want, you can set it with your camera angle. After the place it, let's add some fog around there. First, we will add a cube with Shift A and after that scale for cover up all of scene. Choose your cube and add a fog material. Go to Shading tab. After that, delete your principal BSDF. Add a principled volume here. Connect volume to volume. And after that, we will add a color ramp node. For the color ramp's color, connect to the emission strength. And after that, as the classical, we will add noise texture in here and connect FAC to FAC. From here, go to render and view. You can change your density and after that, with the color ramp's black node, as you see, you can make a bit darker your fog. From the world section, you can set your background and world color. Let's add some lights. We will add an area light in here. From the light settings, you can change your shape to disk and scale it a bit. And after that, you can change your power from here. If you want, you can rotate it or change this color. For the light part, I will making my light emission color a bit blue. If you want, you can add extra detailed parts how you want. I will add a plane for my ceiling detail. I will scale it and E to extrude some part of it for the back and shift it to duplicate this plane. You can make it longer. After that, you can set your material red emission or white emission. For the area lights, I will shift it to duplicate my lights for my scene. I set it my power for the 500. If you want, you can set it as a 100 or different types value. How is your fog dense? You can set it how you want. If you want, from the output settings, you can change your resolution 4K, for example. And after that, go to wireframe, render your image. That's my one gas station liminal space scene will be look like that. If you want, you can add some extra species. After all of that, you can save as your image. Thank you for watching. Please don't forget to like and subscribe. See you later in new tutorials.